Hello everyone, welcome to online classes, standard 8th, subject English, section grammar, unit 14, topic figures of speech, part 2. Let us study what is figures of speech and solve the exercise and write answers of it. Let's begin. Let us study about apostrophe. Here, a direct address is made to an abstract or depth or absent or present person, that is entity. Example, O death, where is this thing? Direct address is made to an abstract death for a better poetic effect, means they directly convert the address to an abstract one. Okay, now what is synecdoche? Here a part of symbolizes the whole and the vice versa. Means here we consider the whole part and its vice versa. Example, his orchards were his bread. Now here orchards and breads are two separate things, but they are considered as a whole and vice versa. Second, a part bread symbolizes the whole livelihood. Now here bread and livelihood is compared and they symbolizes the whole and vice versa. So in this manner we have studied what is synecdoche. 17th one, pun. It is the use of a word in such a way that is capable of giving more than one meaning. Pun means that one word is used in such a manner that it gives double meaning. Example, first, the life of a person depends on the liver. Second, is life worth living now? There can be two meanings arise in both the sentences. Yes and no will be the answer if we are asking the question based on this sentence. So like these types of sentences are considered under pun. Irony. It is a speech in which the real meaning is exactly the opposite of that which is literally conveyed. Means literally opposite meaning is written. Example, but Brutus is an honorable man. Here Brutus is considered as an honorable man, but he was not an honorable man. Second, he is smart. He might not be smart, but it is conveyed that he is smart. So like these types of sentences denote irony as a figure of speech. Next, epigram. It is a brief, interesting, memorable and sometimes statistical and surprising statement. Means it gives brief sentence also, interesting sentences also, memorable sentences also, and sometimes surprising or satirical statements. Example, I can resist everything except temptation. Means he can resist everything but he cannot resist his temptation. The child is the father of the man. Now the child cannot be the father of the man because he is his child only, but this is something brief or interesting poetic line and it is called as epigram. A child gives birth to a mother. Now see, in this manner also wordplay is considered and it is known as epigram. 20. Metonymy. It is a figure of speech that replaces the name of a thing with the name of something else with which it is closely associated. Example, the pen is mightier than the sword. Pen refers to written words and swords to a military force. Now see, two different words that are having different meanings are closely associated for greater poetic effect. We are reading Shakespeare. Now we cannot read Shakespeare, but we read the work written by Shakespeare. So here also mentimony is the figure of speech. My new McTonish is superb. Last one, the school is going for a picnic tomorrow. Now the school cannot go for a picnic, but the children's go. So in this manner, the mentimony figure of speech is considered for greater poetic effect. Now let us study the other ones. 21st one is litotes. It is an understatement in which a positive statement is expressed by negative its opposite. Now, Example number 1. You don't excel at maths. Rather than you are terrible at maths. Means the exact meaning is neglected to its opposite meaning. She is not unhappy. Means she is happy. I am not a little bit surprised. Means it is in great surprise. He is not a fool. Means he is a wise. So like this, double meaning sentences are called as litotes, which are used for greater poetic effect. Paradox. A seemingly absurd or contradictory statement, incapable ideas are expressed. Now see, now incapable ideas means which are having some contradiction in it. Let us study this by understanding the examples. You can save money by spending it. Now see, does it really make a sense? You cannot save money by spending it. So like these statements are called as paradox. This is the beginning of the end. Now see, beginning and end are two completely contradictory words, but they are used in a sentence for making it more interesting and more poetic. Such kinds of sentences are called as a paradox. Another thing of paradox is a paradox can be thought-provoking or funny. Onomatopoeia. Onomatopoeia is a figure of speech where sound is expressed through a word. Means the words which create a sound are used. Crip, whistle, etc. Here crip and whistle are sound words. Zip. My dress was fascinated. Now zip is also an interesting sound made for greater poetic effect. See point. I could bear the buzzing. The pig squealed. Now here buzzing is also used as a word of poetic manner. So this is called as onomatopoeia, figure of speech. Tautology. Here two words with same meaning are placed side by side. Example, the girl was happy and merry. Here happy and merry are having same meaning and they are also placed side by side for greater poetic effect. Next, turmeric is useful and advantageous. Now advantageous and useful are having same meaning and they are also placed side by side for greater poetic effect. Now let us solve the exercise. Identify the figures of speech in the following lines. Justify your answer. First, variety in the spice of life. Now it is metaphor. Oh solitude, where are the charms? Here apostrophe. Death lays its icy hands on kings. Personification. Man proposes, God disposes. Antithesis. He ran like the wind. Simile. You are my sunshine. Metaphor. Seventh. Let the floods clap their hand. Personification. Life is bitter, sweet. Oxymoron. Next is 9th point. A bicycle cannot off hands on its own because it is too tired. Now here it is pun. He came, he saw, he conquered. Climax. He is a great philosopher, a member of the parliament and plays golf well. Now here anticlimax is used because it is all in opposite manner. Her brain is the size of a pea. Hyperbole. Some shiny snakes were slowly slithered. Alliteration. S sound is repeated. The changing pots and pans awoke the body. Onomatopoeia. India won the match. Sinidochi. Question number 2. Identify the figures of speech for the following statements. First one. To believe is to see angels dancing among the clouds. Now it is personification. That life is a gift is metaphor. Every day I met the hawker crying bangles, crystal bangles. Your word is directly repeated, so it is repetition. Fourth point. When the gong sound 10 in the morning. Onomatopoeia. Fifth. I wish I were a hawker. Repetition. I is repeated. I can see through the gate that the house of the gardener digging ground. Alliteration. Nobody takes him to task. Here again alliteration. Eighth point. The street lamp stand like a giant with one red eye in its head. Simile. The news ran swift as light. Again simile. 10. When lo, at his finger first touch, it changed a paste lead. Exclamation. And one by one departed. Repetition. We have no time to stand and stare. Interrogation. Stream full of stars like skies at night. Alliteration. When squirrels hide their nuts in grass. Personification. If the crocodile turn cannibal and bites. Hyperbole. And the last one is, if hyenas were not laugh at keeper's joke. Hyperbole. Why so faint the canary bird sings. Personification. In this manner we have completed this figures of speech and its exercise. Thanks for watching this video. Please like, share, comment and subscribe my YouTube channel, that is Kids Study Fun and Food. Dear students, I hope you are understanding the topic nicely. If you are having any doubt, you can leave your comment in the comment section. Also, you can ask me for any topic if you are planning me to make video on that topic. Bye everyone.